Hi. I want to continue my talk about rotations in sorted trees by looking at how to do double rotations. And the idea of double rotations is, well, a double rotation is really two single rotations. And the first double rotation I'm going to look at will be double rotation for an AVL tree. So in an AVL tree, you decide you need to do a rotation to fix the balance of a tree based on an out-of-balance criterion. And what's involved in this particular out-of-balance criterion is I've got actually three nodes involved, N1, N3, and N2. And this would be the node that would be out of balance. So because of the way I determined that this was the node that was out of balance, this is the node that I need to do the double rotation with. Now let me add my subtrees here as before so that we can keep track of things that are hanging on to us. I'm not going to worry about the specific balance here. I'm only worried about doing the rotation. Okay, so I have once again to do an in-order traversal of this tree. I've got A, N1, B, N2, C, N3, D. Okay, now in an AVL tree, the specific kind of double rotation happens because I have this zigzag structure here. The reason I do this rotation is because of the particular way I computed my out of balance. This will have a difference in height of, say, plus, then this has a difference of height of minus. So that will be what causes the need to have a double rotation here. So in an AVL tree, when I do a double rotation, first I rotate around these two nodes right here, and I'm going to label those nodes so that we can see this, and I'm going to call them X, P, and G, not so much because it's important for the AVL tree, but because you'll see the X, P, and G for different kinds of rotation. So the G stands for grandparent, the P stands for parent, the X stands for this particular node. In this case, there's no reason this node is particular, but I'm using this G, P, and X just to show the current grandparent, parent, and child relationship. Okay, so in my single rotation, first I'm going to rotate around these two right here. So I'll need to pull X up and push P down. So there'll be this rotation around this edge right here. So if I only look at what's going on here, this subtree right here, for my first rotation, I have X rotating up, and then that pushes P down. P's right child is a D, so it's just a single rotation as I had before. X's left child remains the B, and then the C is less than P, greater than X, so it's greater than X, less than P, so here's where the C goes. Okay, the rest of the tree remains the same, just as before. This is my G, and I have A. Okay, let me label my node values with what they are so I don't lose track of that. Those are the actual values. N1, X was N2, and P was N3. So that's my first rotation, and then my second rotation will be around this edge right here with the grandparent and now X. So I'll be rotating around those edges. So rotate up X, down G. Okay, so when I pull up X, I have my X, which has got the value N2, drags along the P, which drags along the D subtree, and then the G gets pushed down, and that pushes also the A down. P has this other child, C subtree. And G has, then there's this B subtree, which was the left child of X. So B is greater than G, but less than X. Okay. So it's less than x and greater than g. So there's my b. Okay, so that, so let me label, put the values on these nodes again so that we can see them. Here's, this is my N1 and P was my N3. So if I go through these, do an in-order traversal just to make sure everything is copacetic, I have A, N1, B, N2, C, N3, D, just as before. And that's a double rotation. So to remind you of a double rotation, this is the node I need to fix for balance for the AVL criterion. I rotate around child, grandchild of that node right there. And then once that rotation is done, then I rotate around the node itself that's out of balance and its new child right there.